Hello there. In this video, I'll show you how to find the fuse boxes in a Mark II Ford Focus. There's one in the cabin behind the glove box, and there's another one in the engine bay.
I'll also explain how to figure out which fuse does what.
I'll then show you how to quickly find out whether a fuse is blown using either a magnifying glass or, hang on, this rather vicious looking tool. Welcome to CarSpy TV.
So let's start with the fuse box in the cabin, which, as I said, is behind the glove box. And that means we need to look right up
there.
Now, this white thing here is the underside of the fuse box, but we can't actually access the fuses themselves yet. To do that, we need to lower this down. So can you see this yellow thumb screw here? We can just loosen that off like this. You shouldn't need any tools. And it drops down like that, but it doesn't fall out. And there's another one of those just up here, which I'll loosen off as well. There we go. And now, as you can see, the fuse box opens up and we can see all the fuses in there.
Okay, so we found one of the fuse boxes, but how do we figure out what each of the fuses actually does? Clearly, that's quite handy when tracing an electrical fault. Well, it's easy. Simply go onto Google and type Ford Focus fuse box diagram, and then the year of your car, in this case 2005, and you'll get a big long list from number 1 to, I think it's 80 something. And then it will say fuse number 1 does this, fuse number 2 does that, and so on all the way down. Let's say, for example, we want to find, what do you reckon? I reckon fuse number 67.
So if we now have a closer look in the fuse box, we can see that under each fuse there's a letter, F, that of course stands for fuse, and then a number immediately adjacent, and this one is the one we're looking for, number 67.
So let's move on to the fuse box in the engine bay.
Now, this particular car has the 1.6 litre petrol engine, and the fuse box is very easy to find. It's just here on the left of the car. Here it is, and we can recognise it in part because it has this picture of a fuse on it, which is a bit of a clue. Now, to remove the lid, it can be a little bit sticky, I find, but what we need to do is just get a screwdriver down there and release a clip. I have slightly loosened this one off camera, and then voila, the lid comes off like so, and there are the fuses.
While we're here, let's just have a quick look at the lid of the fuse box, because it does have a couple of handy little features that make life easier. So let's turn it over. And there we are. We have a nice clear diagram that tells us what the fuses do. So there's no need to rely on Mr. Google. We also have down here some spare fuses. There are 5 now, although there were clearly originally 6. And this red thing. Can you guess what that is? That is a fuse removal tool, or fuse puller, and it makes it much easier to get these things out. Very simple to work. You just grab it like so, pop it on the relevant fuse, give it a squeeze, and pull it out. And that is a lot easier than trying to do it with your fingers. I know from experience.
Now, there are a couple of easy ways we can figure out whether a fuse has blown. The first is to remove it and have a really good look with your magnifying glass. Now, can you see that silver piece of metal that runs all the way through the fuse? If that piece of metal is broken at any point, the fuse has blown and we need a new one. Clearly though, this one is okay.
The other way to see if a fuse has blown is to get yourself a circuit tester like this. And this enables you to test the fuse without removing it from the box. And the main advantage is that it's really quick.
you can test every fuse in the box within a minute or so if you feel so inclined. I'll just quickly summarise how to use it for you. So the first thing to do when using the circuit tester on a car is to connect this metal clip on the end to a grounding point. I tend to use the negative terminal on the battery as much as possible. So the battery on the Mark II Ford Focus is under this cover. So let's get that out the way. And then the negative terminal is down there at the back. So let's get the clip on. And if you can get your hand in and out of this tiny gap without scuffing your knuckles, you're doing better than me. So let's evaluate this 10 amp fuse and see what's going on. To do so, we need to move the tip of the circuit tester between the two pins on the fuse. There's one pin there, and there's the other there, the little silver bits. So let's get a nice firm contact on the first pin. There we are. Now, if we have a look at the circuit tester, we can see, yeah, look at that, it's lit up. Now we need to do the same on the adjacent pin, like that. Have another look at the circuit tester, and it's lit up on that pin as well. That means the fuse has not blown, it's okay. In contrast, if your circuit tester lights up when you touch one pin on the fuse but not on the other pin, that means that fuse has blown and you need to ask Father Christmas for a new one. And finally, if the circuit tester doesn't light up on either pin, if there's no sign of life at all, that means the fuse isn't getting power. Now that might be for a very simple, harmless reason, like the ignition hasn't been turned on, or perhaps there's a fault. Now, a long time ago, I made a video that explains in more detail how to use this circuit tester. There's a link in the description of this video that takes you to that video if you're curious. So there you go. That's how to find the fuse boxes in a Mark II Ford Focus, figure out which fuses do what, and test them. Now, from my perspective, this video hasn't been particularly easy to make. I've had 3 hailstorms, heavy rain, high wind, it's been mighty cold, and there was even a little bit of snow. So if you'd like to continue watching me suffer, don't forget to subscribe to CarSpy TV and do me a favour, will you? And click like on this video. I'm going indoors.